It's time to get you into the ABL Finals action as the Singapore Slingers host the BTN CLS Knights in Game 1 at the OCBC Arena. The Slingers draw first blood at home, or with the Knights come away with a road victory. We go to the first quarter as local MVP candidate Brandon Jawata stroking it from beyond the arc. And Maxi Ejo also with the same result that would spark an 8-0 run for the BTN CLS Knights. Now with 4 minutes remaining, slowly but surely the Slingers would get into this game as Fields would finish with the N1 play, and he was looking to ignite his crowd and his squad as well to get back into this ballgame. And that's exactly what they did as Larry Liu would stroke it from beyond the arc. That triple was a big one, however the Knights would still have the last laugh. Douglas Herring would rise with his three-pointer to beat the first quarter buzzer and give his squad a 20-16 lead at the end of the first period. Now we go to the second frame, where Jaron Young, a full head of steam, getting all the way to the rim, but it would be a slow day for Young as he would be saddled with an injury and would miss majority of the second half. 6:37 remaining, and Alexander rising up to knock down the triple, but on the other side. Check out the strong play from the bull-strong Darryl Watkins of the Knights. Action would pick up once again, this time as Nam Han Bin stroking it from beyond the arc. But every time it seemed like the Slingers were going on a run, the Knights would respond. First that triple from Maxi Ejo, with 28 seconds remaining, the Singapore Slingers would get a triple from Xavier Alexander. However, the Knights would still be down by one at the end of the first half. In the third, this is when the Knights began to put things together. Check out how Watkins tested the rim on that slam and jamma. He would get another one as Herring would find Watkins all the way to the rim with that gorgeous pick and roll action. Watkins once again, as he increases the lead of the Knights to 13 with that N1 play, and he was beasting all over the front court of the Singapore Slingers. Maxi Escher would add to the misery, rising up once again to stuff it all over Xavier Alexander. Eventually, the Slingers would reply as Xavier Alexander would get a three of his own on the other end, but it was just all Knights as they would end the third quarter with a 13-point advantage off of excellent shooting from beyond the arc, and they would head into the fourth with a sizable lead. The Slingers did everything they could to try to get back into this game, but it was an issue of not enough time. And every time it seemed like the Slingers were going to get back into it, guys like Sandy Kurniawan would rise up and hit the triple. The Knights, even though they did not have Wong Wei Long in this game, were still able to take care of business as they put together a team effort to pick up the impressive road victory in game number one. They draw first blood in our series and win 86-67, led by 24 points from Maxi Ejo. Game 2 is on Sunday, once again at the OCBC Arena.